Let's take a few minutes to review a common model for explaining how different factors affect how quickly the liver can clear drug from the body. This particular way of looking at the liver is known as the well-stirred or the jar model. It takes the liver, which is very complicated, and imagines that it's just a single container, a jar if you will. And instead of there being discrete areas in the liver with different concentrations of drug and different enzymatic activity, it assumes that everything is just all well stirred up and distributed evenly throughout the jar. It's sort of like when we talk about a one-compartment model. The human body isn't a single container with the same amount of drug throughout. But for the sake of simplicity, we sometimes treat it like it is. The equation for the well-stirred model looks a little bit intimidating, but it really only has four variables. The first is hepatic clearance, which is how quickly the liver can clear drug from a particular volume of blood. The next is hepatic blood flow, which reflects how quickly drug molecules are being delivered to the liver by the circulatory system. Fraction of free drug in the blood is the amount of drug that is floating around by itself and not bound to albumin and other plasma proteins. And intrinsic clearance is a reflection of how efficient the liver is at getting rid of unbound drug molecules that are presented to it. In 2011, a pharmacy student at the University of British Columbia wrote a paper describing a clever way of thinking about the well-stirred model. What Arden Berry suggested was that students think of the liver as being like a bar or a pub. In this bar are a certain number of stools where patrons buy drinks. The owners like having people sit at the bar, but doesn't like people who wander in, listen to the band, and don't buy anything. So he hires bouncers whose job it is to get the people who are just wandering around to clear out. In this analogy, the people in the bar are drug molecules. Some of them are sitting on stools buying drinks and are thus bound. The bouncers leave them alone. However, there's only so many seats available and everyone else is wandering around free. These are the unbound drug molecules. The bouncer can only clear out so many people at a time. The bouncer represents the liver's intrinsic clearance. So, patrons, that is, drug molecules, being removed from the bar by the bouncers reflects the overall hepatic clearance. What are the things that influence how quickly people, or drug molecules, can be removed? One thing that can change is how many stools are at the bar. Let's suppose that suddenly half the bar stools are removed from the building. Now there are relatively more people walking around because there isn't any place for them to sit. Remember, bouncers only remove people who are walking around and they leave people seated at the bar alone. The percentage of patrons walking around is the fraction of unbound drug. The liver only removes unbound drug. It leaves drug that is bound to plasma proteins alone. The greater the percentage of drug that is floating around free, the more drug is cleared. Next, let's suppose that the owner gets frustrated with the number of people wandering around not buying drinks, so he hires more bouncers. With more bouncers in the bar, more people get cleared out. The bouncers are the liver's intrinsic clearance. Intrinsic clearance might change due to factors such as diseases affecting the liver or interacting drugs that either induce or inhibit the cytochrome P450 system. Finally, let's consider different times of the day. Early in the day, say around 9 a.m., there aren't many people walking around the entertainment district and very few people are coming into the bar. The bar is mostly empty and not many people are being cleared out. But as the day goes on, more and more people are walking around the bar and more people wander into the bar. As the bar gets more and more crowded, more and more people get cleared out by the bouncers. The people walking around the entertainment district and coming into the bar represent hepatic blood flow. When hepatic blood flow is low, not many molecules are finding their way into the liver and not many are getting cleared. When hepatic blood flow increases, lots of molecules get delivered to the liver and relatively more get cleared. So, while the equation for the well-stirred model looks kind of intimidating, remember, it's simply a way of thinking about how changes in hepatic blood flow, fraction of drug unbound, and intrinsic clearance might affect how quickly a drug is removed by the liver.